Hello and welcome to the Daily Transcript Newsroom. Shares and trading volume for Acadia Pharmaceuticals have skyrocketed in the last two trading days, as investors smile on the biotech industry and look forward to third quarter clinical results. And Transcript Technology correspondent Phil Baker writes about some recently introduced gadgets that are designed for use while on the road. Also, already facing antitrust scrutiny in South Korea and the European Union over its technology licensing, Qualcomm may be ordered to change its business practices by Japan's Fair Trade Commission. In real estate news, purchases of new homes in the United States climbed 11% in June, the biggest gain in 8 years. Increases in San Diego have been large as well, but still trail historical norms. In financial news, investors are still building on a stock market rally, even when the news isn't all that great. The Dow rose 15 points to finish above the 9,100 mark for the first time since November 5th. The broader S&P 500 rose 3 points, while the NASDAQ inched up 2. In Washington on Tuesday, the Joint Economic Committee holds a hearing on foreclosures, a Senate committee discusses updating insurance regulation, and a House committee will hold a hearing on the dairy industry. In New York, the Conference Board releases the Consumer Confidence Index, and S&P Case-Shiller will release its May Index of Home Prices. Among major companies releasing quarterly financial results are DreamWorks Animation, SKG, Office Depot, U.S. Steel, Valero Energy, and Viacom. For more on our stories, check out the links below. I'm Doug Sherwin, and thanks for clicking.